Hey everybody, welcome back for day two of our fabulous flamingo drawing. I have just a couple of things I want to talk about for coloring, specific things to how to color this picture, and then you're going to be able to go ahead and color it on your own. So make sure you watch these few things first and then work on your own. The first thing I want to talk about is the color on the flamingo. The flamingo doesn't have a lot of specific colors, but one thing we really want to make sure we do is we want to make sure that the front of the beak is actually black, because the flamingo has this kind of black point on the front of his beak. The rest of his beak is that pink color like his body, but the front is a solid black. So make sure that you color that in just like that. The other thing that we want to do on our flamingo picture is we want to make sure that we color our water to make it look like water. Doesn't matter if you're using crayons, markers, or colored pencils, just like with our sailboat pictures, we want to make sure that we are coloring our water from left to right. So I'm going to go ahead and use crayons for this part so that you can see the difference, but I'm going to start the same way I did with my markers. I'm going to go ahead and go around my objects first, creating that kind of force field or outline around it. Protecting the sand. Don't forget in between the flamingo's legs, we can still see the water coming in between his legs. Around his body, we're trying to get right up next to that. Okay, and then I am gonna grab a table guard again, just to make sure that I don't get the crayon all over my table. And I'm gonna start to color from left to right. You could, kind of like we did with the markers, kind of make it wavy to show those wavy lines. But the other thing you can do is first go in with your watercolor and just fill it in. Big, long coloring brush or coloring strokes. And then you can go back in with the same color or a darker color and add some more of those water lines. And I think I'm going to change colors to make it a little bit stand out a little bit more. There we go. So you can add more of those water lines on top. So layering the colors is a great way to create that texture. Okay, and that's going to make it look like water. The last thing is going to be the trees in the background. I want to create a nice, bright, sunny summer day. So my trees are going to be different shades of green to create that illusion that it is summertime. So I'm actually going to pick out several different colors of green, not just one. If you have multiple colors, use them. Okay. Now, the other thing is trees, unlike water, do grow up and down. So when I'm coloring these, I'm actually going to make my lines go up and down, unlike my water that I went side to side. So it's a different object. So we're going to create that different illusion. So I'm going to start out with this kind of light green and going up into the top of this one, I'm going to make it kind of a light green. And then I'm going to change my green. And for this one, I'm going to make it a slightly different shade of green. So I'm showing that the trees are a little different, and I'm going to kind of overlap those greens to create that effect. And then I'm going to change greens again. And you can change greens as many times as you have different colors, but it's going to create the illusion that these are different trees and not all the same tree. You can also mix the colors. You could go over on top of this and mix some of this lighter green in here. Have fun with it, but creating that effect by using different colors of green in each of those kind of tops of the trees. And you don't have to create a pattern. You could have two trees that are the same color next to each other. And then change again. But again, since the trees do grow up and down, you want to make sure you're kind of coloring up and down on those. All right. If you're not sure what a flamingo looks like, you can look on Canvas. I did leave you a picture of an actual or a photograph of an actual flamingo to look at if you need a picture so you know what they look like and where the colors go. But you can play around with it and make it your own as well. So I'm going to continue coloring mine. go ahead and finish coloring yours, and then don't forget to submit it to Canvas when you're done. And I can't wait to see what you came up with. All right. Bye, everybody.